Hello, my friend. How you doing today? Nice to see you back with us. And today, at the beginning, we've got Booster 7 back in testing. After returning to pad, along Ship 24 tests, followed by Northrop signing 3 launch deals with SpaceX, and finally a glimpse on Polaris Dawn progression. Let's get started with Ship 24 testing and Booster 7's testing after its return to the launch pad. Days back, SpaceX has again rolled out their massive Super Heavy Booster 7 back to the launch pad. According to reports, on the 5th of August, Friday, the Booster 7 prototype had been transported to the Orbital launch pad at Starbase during night for testing, and on the 8th of August, SpaceX started the testing of both Booster 7 and Ship 24. Elon Musk, too, shared the arrival of Booster 7 through his tweets from Starbase on the 6th of August, Saturday. He posted 2 photos. The first one shows B7 on the way to the launch pad. "Moving rocket to launch pad," he tagged. After B7's arrival to the pad, Musk shared the photo of B7 standing beside the orbital launch tower with a tag at launch pad. Just a few days ago, Musk had shared his views and expectations for the first Starship orbital launch. He wrote, "A successful orbital flight is probably between 1 and 12 months from now. So it's quite plausible that SpaceX is working hard and fast as well to get Booster 7 and its Starship upper stage spacecraft ready for the program's first ever orbital test flight, which the company aims to launch in the next few months. SpaceX's present goal is to get Starship to orbit as fast as within a month or maximum within a year. In the first expectation, the launch will be carried out by September 2022. And to fulfill this goal, SpaceX teams will need to complete test and verify both the ship and Super Heavy within the month of August. If we take the second expectation then, the first Starship orbital launch will be pushed back by a year. But still, if SpaceX teams decide to drop B7 and go on with Booster 8 for launch, then possibly they can go for launch within 4 to 6 months. Keeping the 1-month goal in mind, SpaceX teams have kicked off testing of both Ship 24 and Booster 7. On the 8th of August, they carried out 2 spin prime tests on Ship 24, followed by massive venting and further 2 spin prime tests of Super Heavy Booster 7, followed by booster depressurization. A few hours later, SpaceX has conducted a static fire test on both Booster 7 and Ship 24. Musk didn't clearly state how he defines the success for Starship orbital launch. Sources state, if success is defined by simply reaching orbit or deploying a few next-generation Starlink satellites in orbit, then it's plausible that Starship can carry it out. But if success includes a Super Heavy booster catch and Starship surviving its first orbital re-entry, then chances of success are very low till now. In our next update, Northrop Grumman buys 3 SpaceX launches for their Cygnus spacecraft. Recently, Northrop Grumman has signed a launch contract with SpaceX to send 3 Cygnus cargo missions to the International Space Station. Sources state that this contract with SpaceX has come up while Northrop is developing an upgraded version of their workhorse Antares rocket with Firefly Aerospace. Ellen Klicka, an official of Northrop Grumman, stated about the launch contract with SpaceX that the launches will take place in late 2023 and 2024 from the Kennedy Space Center, Florida, in support of the NG-20, 21, and 22 CRS missions. On the 8th of August, Northrop Grumman and Firefly Aerospace publicized that they'll develop a new first stage for Northrop's Antares launch vehicle and a medium lift rocket too in the times to come. Earlier, Ukraine's Yuzhnoye State Design Office and Yuzhmash Machine Building Plant produced the Antares first stage, which was driven by RD-181 engines from Russia's NPO and Ergomash for its upper stages. But in the context of the ongoing Russia-Ukraine war, The Antares rocket production stagnated as supplies of those engines and equipment were cut off by Russia in a response to Western sanctions, which were imposed for its invasion of Ukraine. Report says that Northrop had already completed the first stages for two more Antares launches, the first of which is scheduled for October. But side by side, they were also working on backup options as either the first stage or the engines became unavailable due to the war situation. So the partnership with Firefly resulted. The upgraded version which Northrop and Firefly is developing is called Antares 330. According to sources, the first stage of Antares 330 will comprise 7 Miranda engines under development by Firefly. This stage will also use Firefly composites for their structure and tanks. But the upper stage of Antares will remain the same with the present Antares rocket. Antares 330 is designed to launch from the current pad at Virginia's Mid-Atlantic Regional Spaceport. Earlier Antares launches were used for launching Cygnus cargo missions to the International Space Station. But amidst the Russia-Ukraine conflict, the launch of Antares remains in doubt due to the stoppage of supplies from Russia. So, Antares 330 is planned for Cygnus launch. But according to Scott Day of Northrop, it will take almost 2 years' time to make Antares 330 space-ready, in other words, 2024. So Northrop signed 3 Falcon 9 launch contracts with SpaceX to cover up the space between the last Antares and the first Antares 330 launch, keeping launch of Cygnus cargo missions to the space station continuing. As per sources, Antares 330 will significantly increase the vehicle's payload capacity in comparison to the presently operational Antares rocket. Day explained that while the present-day Antares has a capability of delivering 8,100 kilograms of payload into the insertion orbit meant for space station missions, the upgraded Antares launcher will be capable of delivering almost 10,500 kilograms to the same. Regarding the entirely new medium-lift launcher, both Northrop Grumman and Firefly Aerospace didn't share any details. Today, we'll wrap up with an update on SpaceX's Polaris Dawn mission. We know that SpaceX was training astronauts for the Polaris Dawn mission. Since then, SpaceX has progressed a lot. Back in May, SpaceX teams trained the astronauts for the world's first commercial spacewalk. And according to some recent updates, the first launch of the Polaris Dawn program will be carried out in December 2022 aboard a SpaceX Crew Dragon spacecraft. Jared Isaacman, who's the lead in this program, stated in an air show, "We're looking at the end of the year right now, so likely December." In terms of goals, Polaris Dawn has more to add. Other than the spacewalk from the SpaceX Dragon capsule on a private mission, the first launch is also targeting to send the crew to an apogee of 1,400 kilometers as well as carrying out trial communications with SpaceX's Starlink. Anna Menon of SpaceX, another member of the Polaris Dawn crew, said, "There's a ton of new development that's happening to support that. The suit development that's occurring for this mission is really going to help us learn, and we'll be able to build on this as we go to the moon and ultimately go to Mars. To get there, we're going to try to learn an awful lot along the way," Isaacman concluded. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.